Very good afternoon. My name is Alok Srivastava and I welcome you once again to Network Nuts YouTube channel. So, what's in this video? In this video, I'm going to show you a very simple but a very effective manner to log the access to your services. In my case, I'm going to show you how to log access to the your Xanet based services. To your Xanet based services, I'll do it like this. Now, we all know that whenever you access a service, the activity is being recorded or logged. How to customize that thing and how to redirect the logs of Xanet to your independent or a separate file. Let's do it. So again, for the video, I have my trusted virtual machine. The IP address of this machine is 200.192.168.0.200, and I have a user here, Alok, and I'll give you the example of the telnet service. So I go to xanet.d, I'd open up the respective file, telnet, and I just make the disabled to no, to make that service enabled. So I just save and come out. Now here it is the default configuration. I hadn't changed anything except I had changed it to no from yes, so that the service should be available from a remote machine. So rest, it's all same, everything is same. That's great, that's fine, that's fair enough. I'm always fair, isn't it? Yeah, not my color though. Okay, back to the videos. So I save it, I restart the service, obviously. That's great. Now I go to a remote machine. It is my original machine. Here I do a telnet and I give the IP address 192.168.0.200. 200 is the IP address of my VM. That's great, that's fair enough. I give Alok, I give Red Hat. That's good. That is what is expected. So I am successfully logged in on my server using the telnet service. I do an exit here. I go back to my VM. Now we all know that this activity will be logged under var log message file. That's great. Yeah, here it is. Start. Look, the PID is coming up here and the IP address is coming up here. And when I exit, it shows me this. That's great. That's fair enough. Now, just a moment. I had to check one thing because I had already done some couple of activities. That's great. Fine. Now I want to customize it. I want to log more details. So I open up my telnet file. One thing that you can do is that you can like here I can specify that by default I say now it's something new that what I'm doing. Log on success means when the server is successfully available, what to log. Please log the duration, please log the exit, please log the IP address, please log the PID, and please log the user ID. So these things should be logged whenever the server is successfully available. Then I can also define log on failure. What to log when you have a failure? Or the best thing is that I'll do one thing. I'm not saving anything here. I just copy my telnet files to say telnet.original so that in case I've got something wrong, I can always roll back. Now I can safely open this file. So here, anywhere, I just write here log on success, and then I say please log the duration, please log the exit, please log the IP address, please log the PID, and please log the user ID. That's great. And when the server is not successfully available, might be you had restricted that IP address, might be he is violating your time access control or anything, then in that case please log attempt, please log the IP address who is trying to hit me, and the user ID. So here I had increased the amount of activity that or the information that will be logged. And because I'm using by default the syslog service, I can specify here log type. So obviously by default it is the syslog, because it obviously use the syslog facility. So need not to write it, so I'll just skip it. That will be fair enough. So in case the server is available, please log all these things. In case if there is a failure, means the server is not available because of the time restrictions or IP restrictions or connection per second or instances, then these activities will be recorded. That's great. Save, come out, restart your Xionet service. Fair enough. Go to my machine again. I do a telnet here. I am doing a successful login. That's great. Successfully logged in. Now let's do an exit from here. Go back to the virtual machine and just try to check var log message. You see here it is. It is showing me the PID, the IP address, the durations, everything is coming up. So now you can also check that how much time he had the particular connection. That is good. Now you can also by default the logs are being sent to var log message because of the default configuration in the syslog. You can redirect your logs to a specific file, because here it's very difficult to search for the telnet logs. It's very difficult to search for the whole message file. So why not have a separate file that will be storing the logs for the telnet? Why not have a separate file that will be storing the log for another service? So let's do it. So in that case, I'll just open my telnet file. So you can specify here, say log type. Log type, by default it is syslog. So instead of syslog, you can redirect it to a file. Say file where log, say I give my telnet.log, any file name that suits your fancy or the name you like. So in this case, activity regarding the telnet with these information will be logged in this file. I hope that makes sense. I restart the service once again. Let's check it out. So I go back to my machine. I do a telnet here. I do a alloc. I give password. That's great. That's great. And wait for a couple of seconds. So fine. I do exit here. Exit. Let's see what happened. Now var log. I have a file here. That's wow. My telnet.log file. It's automatically been created. I just reduce the font size so that you should be able to see it. That's great. It records activity, duration, everything in a separate log file. So that makes the monitoring much more easier. Now let's record a failure. How the failures will be recorded. So now I'm doing the telnet from my base machine, and the IP address of my base machine is 253. Fine. So now I will block this IP address in the telnet. I go back here again, I increase the font, I do a telnet. I intentionally, anywhere here, you know all these things, or you can refer my earlier videos where I had shown you how to control these activities. I say here no underscore access. So I'm intentionally blocking 192.168.0.253, that this particular IP is not allowed. Now when I will try to hit from this IP address, this activity will be logged in this file. Save and come out, restart the Xionet service, of course. Go back to the machine. Now I'll try to hit it. I'm blocked. I know, but he's trying. Now let's see. If I open this file again, whoa, look here. I'll just reduce the font size. That is good. Look, it has got a fail telnet address from this. So in this manner, you can have a separate log file that will be storing your relevant information for the success events as well as the failure events. So that makes your monitoring much more easier, and you are able to log access to your services in a much more efficient manner. Is that clear? I hope I had made myself clear, and I hope this video will be useful to you. Thank you once again. God bless. See you soon. Stop the video now.